Hello everyone, I'm Adam from New Horizon Code. Today I'll be teaching you how to bulk upload users into your Bubble database. Though this may seem simple, there's a few things we need to do to get this function to work. Firstly, if we look at how Bubble works, we'll notice when we try and upload a data via CSV, nothing's going to happen. Because if we have a look at the workflow options, you'll see within here that when we attempt to upload, we don't have the option to access that user data type. But luckily for us, there's a few ways to get around this. Let's have a look. Firstly, we'll have a look at how I've done it. So in this example, I'm going to first upload a CSV file. Once this is completed and uploaded, it will then generate our user accounts using some simple backend workflows. Once the CSV is uploaded, we will process our request, and you'll now start to see every 5 seconds generate a user account. So there's the first one, second one, and so on and so forth. Once this is completed, I'll join you guys and we will show you how to do it. Great, now that's finished, so let's have a look at how it's done. Firstly, we have a workflow that checks for when the upload value is changed and the upload percentage is 100%, we upload data as a CSV. As you can see, because we can't upload it as a user data type, we've generated this data type called temp hold, and CSV file is that of the file uploader's value. So once it's uploaded, it now would have generated all these accounts in temp hold, so we can now do what we want with them. What's the data types within temp hold? Well, simply there's one called test text. Though for the sake of this demonstration, I'll rename it to emails, and this is uploaded all user emails. Then we've got our next button, which is process request. What this does is schedules an API workflow on a list. The list is temp hold, as we previously spoke about, and we search for every temp hold. You can add constraints, but for the sake of this demonstration, we won't be. We then have an API workflow called create accounts, and we've scheduled it for right now. We can also add further to that, so we can start it a day from now or 2 days from now, or wherever you see fit. Next, we've got intervals, which is set to 5 seconds. Bubble constraints don't allow you to make it anything less than 5, but you could make it greater than 5 seconds. If we need to, we can ignore privacy rules on running this workflow. Because this is a test app, we don't have any privacy rules set up. The email is each temp hold's email address. So within this API workflow, we store one thing, a key set to email, and the type is temp hold, because that's the data we're uploading. Then we create an account for someone else, which is the email's email. We can return it if it already exists, and best practice, once it's completed, is to schedule an API workflow to delete all data in the temp hold section. So let's dig into this one more time, and we'll show you what's happening in real time. So to do this, I'm going to add debug mode true to my browser and run it step by step. Firstly, I'm going to delete users. So this will delete every user in my database. So now that we know what's happening in the back end, let's go step by step in the front end. So firstly, I'm going to upload a file. That file is all these sort of email addresses. As you can see, we'll now see what happens. So we're checking that the file uploader's percentage is 100, which it is because this is green. So then we run next, which is upload data. We're uploading the data to temp hold, and the CSV file that we're selecting is that we just uploaded. We can now run next. From here, we would have uploaded every single user into the database, but then not yet user accounts. So we need to process that request. The next thing that's going to do, schedule an API workflow on a list at the current date and time, and we search for each temp hold's email. So as you can see, it's producing a list of all the email addresses. And we can now run that. And now every 5 seconds, it's going to generate a user account until it completes that CSV file. So guys, that's the end of today's lesson. I hope you've learned something new and can continue your Bubble journey. Feel free to head to bubblelessons.com and book 3 free lessons. totaling 90 minutes with me. Bye.